Well, thank you for coming. I have a lot going on in this little video. These colanders I picked up at Target for $1.99, and these containers I got at Costco. These three came in a set for $19.99, and I'm going to be cleaning and cutting a whole lot of produce. So I just set everything.
This is an organic veggie wash that I picked up at Whole Foods.
I think I have everything ready to start, and I got that little rose plant at Trader Joe's, but I have my colanders in my sink. I'm going to use my fruit and veggie wash. This is plant-based, and it's at Whole Foods, and it's inexpensive. And then I like to put everything in clear containers in my refrigerator so I can see what I have. When things are out of sight, they tend to be out of mind. And I'm gonna start with my celery. And I'm gonna prop the camera in a way that you can kind of see me cut my celery. I do a quick chop just because I have so much to wash and chop. I have a lot of celery because we go through a lot of celery. It's one of the most popular vegetables in my household. I put it in salads, I put it in recipes, soups. I put cheese on it for snacks. I cut it up, dip it in ranch dressing, and don't forget, I'm going to share another video of how I make my ranch dressing, which is so yummy. And then celery, I also cut it, some of them in thin slices, so that's easier to eat. I stick them in lunches, you name it. We use celery. Oh, juice, most important. I juice with it. The sink already has some water in it with the spray, but I'm just rinsing it a little bit more. I ended up cutting and cleaning a whole bunch of celery, broccoli, radishes, carrots, green beans. I had some edamame. Let's see. Tomatoes. I always ask the produce man to help me pick out the best melon because I don't always have the best luck. But when I do get the melon, I cut it up and I put it in containers, and I notice that if I do it this way, everybody eats it. And after you cut it up, and do you put salt on your melon, on your cantaloupe? Let me know. Do you put pepper on your cantaloupe? Let me know. But then I just put the lid on it and I put it in the refrigerator, and then it's there for the week.
I'm going to take this parchment paper and put it on this cake stand, and then I'm going to put my cinnamon rolls on it.
Okay, so I've transferred the cinnamon rolls onto the glass pie dish, cake dish, and I just think it looks so much prettier out of the box and into the pretty dish. So, what kind of cinnamon rolls do you like? Totally noisy in here. Do you hear my bread maker in the back? And that's my, I love, love, love my egg maker. It makes hard-boiled eggs, soft-boiled eggs, medium-boiled eggs. And now it's time for much-needed coffee. This is coffee number 5,621. I think I've asked you this before, but what is your favorite coffee to drink? I love the Donut Dark and Dunkin' Donuts, and Kroger has a really great brand of coffee. And you know, who am I kidding? I love all coffee, all of it. And let's peek on my brownies. They're coming up so nice. And then let's look at the bread. Okay, I am about to make some bread. I'm going to put this in my bread maker. I will share the recipe, my very best bread roll recipe. Put that in, goes on in, and we go to menu, and I go to just the toll, number 8, and that'll go, there it goes. And I will show you what it looks like when it's done. See, look at this rise. It goes all the way up to the top and touches the glass at the top sometimes, and it goes all the way over. And it really is the most simplest bread recipe. And when I make my rolls, sometimes I make them bigger or smaller. It's just depending on my mood, but it doesn't matter. They come out perfect each time. And the ingredients are simple and fresh and clean. I cover them and I put them in the oven in a warm place for about 40 minutes to rise. And then after about 40 minutes, I will bake them for 12 minutes. Okay, so now we are on to my beans. I am going to just put them in a bowl with some fresh water, and I'm going to soak them overnight. And then I will put them in a crock pot with my ham bone, and I will cook them according to the directions, usually. There they go. Okay, so let me know. Do you soak your beans? And if you do, what kind do you like? What kind do you like to buy? What kind do you like to make? You must cover them really well with water, because they will get bigger. When you wake up in the morning and you uncover them, they'll be like double in size. It's pretty neat. Great Northern beans are really good. A really good white bean. And there, I cover them with plastic wrap just to protect them from getting any dust or anything in them. And then I'll put them aside and let them soak. Let them do their thing overnight. Okay, let's peek at the bread. Let's see the rise. Look, 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 look. Oh, there they are. First off, the house smells amazing. And second of all, look at how beautiful they are. They turned out perfect. And then I brush them with butter, and then that's all there is. And then I put a lid on it and I set them on the counter, and anybody can eat them. They're good for sandwiches. They're good for lunches. I serve them with dinner. I'll cut them in half. I'll sprinkle some garlic on them, put some cheese in it. They're really, really good. And my house smells amazing. Happy Sunday. I am going to go for my run, and then I put together my bean soup in the crock pot, and I will put the recipe down below so you can look at it, but I will show you what it looks like. I've got the ham in it, and onion, and garlic, and carrots. So I'll show you what that looks like. Okay, it's already starting to smell amazing too. There should be lots and lots of ham in there. So, it's gonna cook all day, and then I will, oh yeah, the bay leaf, forgot the bay leaf. But I'll put the recipe in the description so you guys can see it or use it if you would like. Happy day. It is coming along so nicely. Everything is getting cooked tender, the ham is falling off the bone, and the house is smelling glorious between the bread and the bean soup with the ham. Okay, so if you notice, I'm calling it bean soup, but I do serve it as a side along with my entrees, with the steak or the grilled pork chops in a little serving dish. And some like more juice than others, so some of it's kind of a soup for some of it's just a side of beans for others.
And I am about to cook some ground beef for my pasta bake, and I had stopped at Lidl. Never been there. It's far away, but it intrigued me, and I went there and I bought some pasta sauce. It kind of reminds me, I thought it was like with IKEA, but it's not. It reminds me of a like a Aldi's kind of. I hear a dog. Hold on.
She's saying hello to the little dog across the street. She's got a friend. Okay, so anyway, I went to Lidl, and they say it rhymes with needle. But so I bought this organic sauce, and I haven't been back. It is really far away. I mean, it's the farthest grocery store. But I wanted to try it. And it's a really cute store. So if you have one, you should try it. It's cute. It reminded me of an Aldi. My ground beef is in the pan. I am going to fry this up, and then I'm going to make my, continue to make my pasta bake with the noodles and the sauce, and then some garlic bread and salad. I'll show you the finished product. Okay, I hope you, it's Monday. I don't know if I said that. I'm running some water in my sink so I can wash all the dishes that I dirty. So I will see you in a bit.
Okay, so this just came, and I'm thinking, okay, so I have a Peloton, and I've had it for over 2 years, and the heart monitor, it's a strap that goes around your chest strap. And it started not reading my heart rate and kind of dropping my numbers, and it wasn't really giving me an accurate reading on my Peloton, if that makes sense. There's all sorts of the resistance, the cadence, the heart, the calories, and then you're on the leaderboard. And there's a whole bunch of things that go on with that bike, and I need that heart rate monitor for the full experience and to know where I'm at and what I'm doing. So this is the heart rate monitor that I was told that was compatible with the Peloton. I did not want another chest strap. I didn't particularly care for it. Plus, I'm small there, and so it was really hard for it to stay on, and it would slip, and I had to figure out a way to keep it on. But this goes around your wrist, so I'm gonna see how this works, and I'm super excited for this. And I'll let you know. Let me know if you have a Peloton also. Okay, checking in. My ground beef is cooking beautifully. And then when I was at the store, they had these nut-free. I thought these were so precious. They're vanilla with cream with a dollop of strawberry. That is so happy. Happy, happy, happy. And then I wanted to show you these. I put my oil and my vinegar in these containers. I had some Kohl's cash. And so I got these bottles. They look so pretty. And I think they look pretty on my counter. And I was really excited to put them on my table for Easter. So if anybody wanted oil and vinegar on their salad. And then I needed to fill up my regular pepper shaker. I have the magic salt and pepper shakers. I got that from my husband a couple years ago for Christmas. Where do you buy a man that buys whatever, he buys what he needs. He buys what he wants. So I thought the magic salt and pepper shaker were pretty neat. And if I do say so myself. And then I needed calcium gummies. You gotta watch out for those because those are so good. And okay, let's check my ground beef again. It is cooking. He's cooking. I'm going to drain the grease. Do you drain the grease? I have to drain the grease. And then I'm going to cook noodles. And I don't know what kind of noodles I want to cook with this. I could do mesticcioli. I could do ziti. I could do actual spaghetti. I could do macaroni. Or penne. What kind of pasta do you like? Maybe mesticcioli, because that the sauce holds onto that really well and makes it taste really good. But then everybody likes the spaghetti. We'll see. I'll see what I have the most of. Okay. Okay. Okay, so for my pasta and my pasta bake, I decided on shells. I got these at Whole Foods, the organic shells. And I will pair that up with the organic marinara that I got from Lidl. Rhymes with needle. Do you hear my water going? Here it goes. All right, I'm going to put the noodles in the water. Okay, I cooked the noodles, drained the ground beef, and I put it all in this pan, and I'm gonna add the sauce. And I have some mozzarella cheese in my refrigerator that I'm gonna use. I'm gonna put some in there. And then at the end, I'm gonna top it with cheddar because my family likes cheddar cheese. So I'm gonna mix in some mozzarella and bake it. And then I'll top it with cheddar. So this is it. I was going to put some other vegetables in. Sometimes I put like peppers and onions and garlic, but I'm just going to do it very simple today because simple always wins. But also I'm going to make a really nice green salad to go with it with all the vegetables that I was going to put in here. So that is my pasta bake, and I'll show it to you when it's all done. Okay. Okay, I put the sauce in here, and I have got to tell you that this sauce from Lidl smells absolutely amazing. It smells so good. You could just smell all like the fresh garlic and basil. Oh my gosh, it smells super good. Oh, I just had to come back down here and tell you. And I'm waiting for these avocados to ripen, but I have some other ones that are already ripe. This is probably one of the number one staples in my house is avocado. Okay, so I have baby romaine, an iceberg for the crunch, some of the hard-boiled eggs, tomatoes, avocados, cheese, celery, cucumber, yum, fresh green salad. Let's take a peek at this. Look at all that cheese. Oh my goodness. This smells so yummy, and it's so cheesy, and it's simple, and it's so good. Let me know if you make pasta bake and how you make yours. This one was a win. Yum. Okay, this is my garlic cheese bread, and I got this idea from looking at the bread in the freezer section at the grocery store. It's just sliced bread, buttered with garlic salt, cheese, and then I put it in a hot oven until everything is melted and toasted, and then I serve it alongside my pasta bake or whatever dish I make that day, that evening. I hope you've enjoyed this. Bye!